We have Ken Lalime with us. Ken, I know from, what was it, Access Health CT? Wasn't that the cooperative?
Healthy CT.
Healthy correct. CT, yes. And I still have a nice keychain they gave me, which I remember. But Ken, you've kind of changed paths a little bit into a new venue. For it's been 2 years for you, I believe.
Just about, yep.
And this is, of course, you know, it's basically, I love these community health centers. And seriously, you've heard me talk a lot about them. But they're all over the state. And, I mean, 10% of the state's population. You cover a lot of people.
That's a lot of people. 400,000 people come to community health centers every year. About 1 million visits or more.
What if, okay, because one of the things that's going to be talked about, I guess, I'm hoping, in the next presidential campaign is going to be, you know, do you get rid of Obamacare? Do you replace it with something else? Do you go Medicare for all? How do you go here? You know, and so that's going to be one of the big topics. It's always seemed to me that you guys are a really, really good option.
Well, thank you. Absolutely
no,
agree.
Seriously, it seems
no matter
simple.
What model comes forward over whatever period of time, the need for good primary care health care.
Which is a big problem.
Which is what gets delivered at a community health center. It is a coordinated model of primary care to anyone in the state. Anyone can walk in the door, whether you have insurance, don't have insurance, Medicare, Medicaid, whatever it may be, you get treated. And you're treated in a manner that is, I think, extremely unique. So I've been in this business a long time.
Yes, you have.
And a unique model where you can get primary care, behavioral health care, and oral health care all under the same roof, all at the same time, coordinated, is just, it's very unique. I mean, I kind of look at it and say it's the best kept secret in the state.
Well,
who came
up with the concept?
Well, the concept's been around for a long time, 50 years kind of time frame, and it was really born of the need for taking care of those patients who didn't have resources.
Fair enough.
So that's where it started, and it has grown to basically be, I mean, they're not you know, clinics anymore. These are health centers.
No, I've been in and one or two of them. They're great.
Everybody should take a look. They're in your community. Everybody's amazed when you say, geez, 90 locations around the state. They are in your backyard, and sometimes you don't even know it, but they provide a very comprehensive, coordinated model.
Right.
I just think there's this acronym that gets used that's called patient-centered medical home.
Yeah, well.
And they all are patient-centered medical homes because the patient is the focus.
Well, the other thing I think is cool is when you go upstairs, the one in East Hartford and on Main, and you go upstairs, and I mean, there's, you know, a phone bank of people that are calling to how you're doing, you know, making sure you're going to make your appointment. Do you need a ride to your appointment? I mean, it's patient-centered, no doubt.
And it's that coordination piece is just so critical, and it's unique.
Well, keep thinking about this, kids. We're going to do this, 844 WTIC, back with Ken in a minute. Ken Lalime's with us from Community Health Centers, which, as he explained to us just a moment ago, is about 50 years old.
That's right.
And this is a place where it's kind of the triple crown, in a sense. You can get your primary care.
Yep.
You can get your teeth looked at. That's always an amazing thing when they do the Mission of Mercy thing. And there are people lined up starting at the night before to have their teeth looked at. And that's a key part of health.
It certainly is, growing and growing.
And the mental thing, I guess, is part
behavioral
three.
Behavioral health. That's the other piece. And that has, because of the opioid crisis, behavioral health has been a focus. You know, a lot of things in the news are bringing focus on behavioral health needs. And people should not feel that, you know, this is primary care behavioral health. This is integrated care with your medical needs.
It's all here.
And it's all here. Instead of having to go one place for your medical needs, somewhere else for your behavioral health needs, patients find that, you know, it's kind of a difficult transfer
sometimes.
No, it's true. You
get lost. It's a maze.
And this way, when you as the patient are the center of the care,
right,
it just flows nicely. It really does.
That's just crazy talk is what that is.
Yeah.
So, what are you talking about? I got stockholders I got to take care of. Come on, back off. But, you know, the other thing is it does save money. And I really wanted to hit that because the last time we were talking is that, you know, for a lot of people, you talk about the lack of primary care. And in a lot of places, it just isn't there. Nobody's hanging a shingle there. It's not going to happen. So what do? Your kid gets a fever in the middle of the night. You're going to the emergency department.
Yep.
And that is very expensive.
Absolutely.
Somebody's got to pay for it.
Well, we'd like to see patients more go to urgent care. And some of the health centers have relationships with urgent care.
Has that helped a little?
Help staff it. Yep. But during, you know, if you can get to a primary care center with your kid before those things happen, you know, the difference is night and day. You can have so many visits to a physician or to a center,
right,
compared to the $1,500 or $1,600 it costs to go to the emergency room. You can get, you know, a year's worth of care plus at a community health center. You know, it's just, you know, it's the same number is in the $500 to $600 range versus the $1,500 to $1,600 range.
Ken, if you get to a situation where, you know, the primary care kind of gets you started, they kind of diagnose what's going on here, what needs to be done. Then from there, let's say you need another level of care. Not that I'm saying the guys in the trenches aren't good. They are. But I'm saying there's some things that other people specialize in.
Absolutely.
So how do you do it with you guys?
Well, in that case, we have the primary care center, the health center, has a relationship with specialists in the marketplace that they would refer you to, and then help you coordinate that care. So it still puts that patient in the center. Mm-hmm. You just add, I kind of look at it as a football team, right?
Okay.
So that primary care person, that nurse practitioner or physician, whatever it may be, is the quarterback. You know, you got your guys in front of you that are the good blockers and all the rest. And then you bring in the specialist, you bring in the wide receiver, you bring in the tight end, and you bring those in as you need them.
Yeah.
And then it gets coordinated by that quarterback.
You know, go ahead, Ken.
No, that's
finishing your thought. But I mean, the thing is, and I have a way of doing that. Sorry. Just jump ahead.
Okay.
But I want to, you know, one thing I really want to stress, and you did in the outset, is that, you know, even if you have Cadillac insurance from your employer, it is an option for you.
It is an option.
You know, it's
most of the centers have relationships with all the major payers. They do see a lot of patients that have Title 19 for Medicaid.
Right.
We do Medicare. Somebody moves from being 64 years old to 65 years old, they move into Medicare. The centers will take care of it. It's that total, you know, coordination of care. Take care of you when you're sick. Let's move to wellness here. Let's not only treat people when they're sick. Let's get into the mode of continuous care, and that becomes primary care for life.
By the way, Ken is the president CEO of
just CEO actually.
They're not president.
Not president.
Anymore?
No,
what they do?
There's a board of directors.
They impeach you. What's going on?
No.
CEO of the community. It seems to be all the rage now. CEO of the Community Health Center of Connecticut. And once again, just to give you an idea, 17 around here, 10% of the state's population they treat, 400,000 people, if you want to do math. And so we're just kind of getting awareness here that it is an option. And, you know, I suppose the number of things that come to mind, one is one thing I did want to hit was, okay, see, I think there's something else going on in overall. And that's, you know, the CVS, okay, Aetna merger. I think there's more to it than that. I think part of it is, if you'll notice, CVS has a lot of, as you mentioned, minute clinics, mm-hmm. you know, our quick clinics. And so you go in there and, you know, that could be your source of healthcare, I suppose.
It could be not very coordinated healthcare, but it could be at least a one pop. I mean, I'd rather have people get care than not get care.
Right.
But I think in a place where you can get it coordinated is key. And the reason we're talking about all this stuff, and the reason that I'm here really this week, special week in
community health. Oh, why is it?
Health.
I'm sorry.
So this is the
there it is.
There you go.
Do you want me to do it, or you
right
want to? Hey, by the way, kids, it's National Health Center Week.
There you
I think
go.
I need to pay you a visit probably later this morning. I'm kind of losing some mental acuity
and
here.
So there's lots of things going on in the state. There are, you know, health fairs going on, and you know, great activities at all the. And these are that big word community.
Mm-hmm.
That is such a big part of this. The community is your health resource. So that center, mm-hmm. that health center that you go to, has those resources for you. And this week, check our website, chcact.org. There are activities going on from, you know, face painting to immunization day to, you know, lots of different activities to bring awareness forward.
Yeah.
Backpack giveaways, you know, lots of stuff going on. Check our website. There's a full list of all the events.
Ken, if you look at the stats, of those 400,000 people, what's the demographic breakout? Do you know offhand?
Yeah, by age groups, it's about 32% kids, 60% adults under Medicare age, and then about 10 that are Medicare eligible.
So that's a really good balance.
It's a beautiful balance. It's total life.
And you mentioned, as a matter of fact, you know, continuity of care, who was using that for a while, somebody was. But the backpacks and the immunizations for kids, that could be a big deal for you.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And, you know, we treat on the other side of that population stuff is about 60% of the patients are Husky eligible. 30% are combined insurance. And then there's this big category of, I don't have insurance. What do I do?
Yeah.
Health centers take care of anyone that walks in the door.
So how do you, where do you get your money then?
Well, there's some federal dollars that are allocated to health centers based on their treatment of patients in need.
Okay.
And so there are some dollars there available to the health centers to do that so that people don't fall through the cracks. So they don't use the emergency room.
It's a decent
room.
Thing to do.
It's the right thing to do.
Yeah.
And that's where it's somewhere that the government has started this and been funding this for quite some time.
You know, it is remarkable. One thing I've heard from people in, you know, your area of the world is that sometimes, like, for example, Husky Plan or Medicaid, essentially, that they, in fact, the reimbursement rates are kind of low. They improve somewhat?
Well, it's enough to cover cost at the health center side. That's very helpful. It's not the business.
But they're not paying the full boat.
There's enough to get that health care that you need from a centralized function.
So if you know, even if you have a place to go, they're great. If you don't have a place to go, they're really great.
They're really great.
And how many locations do you have all over the state?
There's about 90.
Okay, you're East Hartford. You got three there, I think.
That's right. So there's 17 actual entities, you know.
Right.
And each of those have multiple sites that you can go to, and there's a lot of them that are really based in the school system. So school-based healthcare is a really good deal because that way you're catching the kids where they are.
Yeah.
You're going to them. You know, you're bringing it.
And so you're giving them backpacks. So what more do you want? What more do you want?
Well, we want them to get care. We want them to make sure
that's nice.
And primary care is such a big part of what this is. You know, this country has lived on sick care for a long time.
Yeah.
I think it's time that we convert that and turn it into well care. And we go visit for keeping people healthy is a lot cheaper than treating them when they're sick.
You mean I've got to change my diet? Get the heck out. I'm taking my chances again. Give your website again, please.
chcact.org.
Okay. Seriously, I've been in a couple of their places. They're really nice. It's not like a welfare clinic, okay? Ken, it's always good to see you.
Great to see you too.
It's been a while. It's been too long, buddy.